In this video, you and I will go through the process of scheduling a team meeting. Let's get started and dive in. All right, so the first thing we'll do is we'll go to calendar. So here we can schedule a meeting, and meet now is how we can have a on-demand meeting. And we'll check out meet now later, but for now we'll focus on a schedule meeting. All right, so we'll go to new meeting. So here we can enter a title. Let's say marketing review. For required attendees, I can type in names of folks in my environment, like Meyer, along with Pedro. I also have the ability to put in an email address that's external or outside of my environment. So here we have an option for optional. So maybe Sierra is my peer, so she doesn't really have to attend this meeting, but if she wanted to, she could. So we can add her there. So next we have our date for our meeting, also a start time and an end time. We can toggle all day here. So let's say this was a training session. It took the entire business day, so I can use that option here. Let's say this was a reoccurring meeting, so I can set the time or the frequency of the reoccurrence. So daily, weekly, monthly, or even custom. I do have the ability to schedule this meeting inside a certain team channel. Let's go ahead and pick sales. And then within sales, let's do leads and prospects. Now everyone in the channel will be able to join and view this meeting. But for now, we won't do that. So let's say this was an in-person meeting. So I can say this meeting will occur in conference room A or conference room B or some physical location. And I have a toggle here for online meeting. And what this means for us is that Teams meeting link is automatically created. If we scroll down a little bit more, so I can add details here about this meeting. Just for my demo, I'll put bring coffee. And I also have the ability to add an agenda. I do feel agendas are important because they keep everyone in the meeting on track. They tell the folks invited to this meeting what the meeting is about, what will be discussed, and also in what order those topics will be discussed. This does help people come to the meeting prepared. All right, going to the top here, the default is show as busy. This allows you to do is control how this time appears on your calendar. The status here will inform anyone who's looking at your calendar about your availability. All right, so we'll keep busy there. Some people like to color code their meetings based on category. We have our default time zone, but we can definitely change this in the event we're scheduling a meeting across the globe. And we also have response options. So here we are requesting a response. So we want a RSVP that folks will be attending this meeting. We also can allow the forwarding of this meeting to other participants. So someone like Pedro can forward this meeting to someone else that he feels that should be part of this meeting. So here we have additional options, but we'll explore these in a future video. I almost forgot the scheduling assistant. This assistant allows us to see everyone's availability, therefore helping us to find a time slot when all the required participants are indeed free. At the end of the day, our goal here is to avoid scheduling conflicts. So here in my demo environment, you see my folks are not very busy, but in your production environment, that definitely would not be the case. All right, let's go back to details. I want to show you before I hit send here, if we go to Pedro and go to his calendar. So we don't see anything here. How about Mara? Go to her calendar. Nothing there. Let's go to Sierra. Do the same thing. And we see nothing here. I'm going to hit send. So here we see our calendar invite. If I go to Pedro, we see it right there. The same should apply for Mario and also Sierra. All right, so what I'm going to do is join this meeting. We are going to talk about these options here shortly, but for now, I'm going to hit join now. All right, I'm currently in that meeting. I'll do the same for Pedro. We'll hit join. What you see here is the pre-join screen. As I stated, we'll talk about all these options later, but for now, we hit join now. We'll do the same for Meyer and do the same for Sierra. All right, so here's our meeting. We have myself, Pedro, Myra, and Sierra in this meeting. In the upcoming videos and skill, we'll definitely talk about all the different options that you see here. But for now, we'll hit leave. If I look in the other folks, they're still in that meeting. For the reason being, if I wanted to end that meeting for everyone, what I would have to do is go here and end the meeting, not just leave. So if I do that, so we get a prompt here. Are you sure? Because you're going to end the meeting for everyone. So we choose end. And what should happen is that everyone else has now also left that meeting. So in this video, we went through the process of scheduling a meeting and looking at the different options that were available to us.
Thanks for watching. If you're interested in an IT career or looking to brush up your IT skills, check out cbtnuggets.com and sign up for a free trial.